And I like to break out the board games this time of year. Not long ago, I played a game of Jenga with some friends, and a couple of days after that, I was talking to my dad on the phone. I thought I'd tell him about it. And then I thought, I don't know if my dad knows what Jenga is. He's in his 70s. I don't know when it first became popular, so I thought I'll ask him. So I said, Dad, do you know what Jenga is? And he said, yeah, like sex. I said, Jenga. He said, sex. I had so many questions, and I didn't want any of the answers. I said to him, I said, can I ask which word you think I'm saying? And he said, yeah, gender. I was like, oh, thank Christ for that. I had a horrible idea that that's what him and my mum called it. He tried to pull himself out without toppling her over. A few months ago, I went for a bra fitting. Give us a woo if you've ever been for a bra fitting. Give us a woo if you did not enjoy it. Exactly the same people again. It's quite an odd experience, isn't it? I've been touring and asking the women in my audiences what they didn't like about their bra fitting. One lady shouted out cold hands. That's what she said. I didn't like the cold hands. And I get it, because they have to touch you at various times, and cold hands aren't very pleasant to touch, but I had a think about it. I think I prefer cold hands to warm hands. Warm hands kind of ick me out. Warm hands imply to me that they've been doing this.
Ooh. Ooh, Sheila, I've seen me 10 o'clock, I cannot wait.
There's another lady shouted at her. I said, what didn't you like about your bra fit? And she said, it was embarrassing. I said, of course it's embarrassing, flower. But I said, was there one moment that was worse than the rest? She said, oh yes. When I took my bra off, two bits of popcorn fell out. One lady shouted out that she thought there were too many mirrors, and I get that. I think there are too many mirrors in those cubicles. Because when I went for mine, the lady said to me,
and would you like to look at the back of the bra?
And I thought, no. And then I thought, I wonder if I'm missing out on something. So I had a look. Turns out I've got back tits as well. I didn't know about those. Thanks for pointing them out, you cow. I'm surprised you didn't try and sell me a bra for the back ones and all. But I'll tell you what happened to me. So every now and again, I have to have a photo shoot. Now, I hate photo shoots. I have really bad body image issues. So a photo shoot for somebody like me is a nightmare, but sometimes they're unavoidable. And I had two in the space of a fortnight, one for the cover of my book and one for the poster for my tour. And I had a lady who's helped me pick some clothes for the photo shoot. And I said to her, look, I don't have the time or indeed the inclination to lose any weight, but I said, could you recommend anything that might make me look a bit better? And she said, go for a bra fit. And she said, a properly fitted bra will knock pounds off you. And I said, how many bras could I wear? Front tits, back tits, ass cheeks, maybe? I don't know. The place she recommended to me was, until about 3 months ago, known as the Queen's Bra Fitter, which I find quite an odd boast, don't you?
Oh, we do the Queen's bras. We do the Queen's bras here. Yeah.
I find that such an odd boast. I've never once watched Troopin' the Colour on the telly and thought, oh, I wish I had tits like hers. I made an appointment at the place she recommended. I went along to the appointment. Went to the cubicle with the lady I'd made the appointment with, and I took off my top and I had my best bra, and you always wear your best one, don't you? I had my best bra. And that's what I said to the lady. I said, this is my best fitting bra. And she went like this. She said, that's what everyone says. I said, well, maybe that's what everyone means. Like, we didn't hit it off at all. It was eggy from the get-go. She said, what we need to do with those two, like they're separate from my person. What we need to do with those two is lift and separate. Lift. And separate. I said, well, don't separate them too much, because that's what it looks like when I'm in bed. The way she was talking, it sounded like she wanted them to look like a travel pillow. She gave me a bra to try on, and I said to her, would you mind stepping out of the cubicle while I put on the bra, and then when I've got it on, I'll shout you back in. She looked utterly perplexed at this. She said, I've been doing this for 30 years. I said, well, I haven't been doing this for 30 years. And then I thought, showing my boobs to strangers, probably a good 25. But I didn't want to add it to my list of people who've seen my tits. There's not that many people on my list, just a handful of blokes and a window cleaner once by accident. So we got a bra that fit, and she tightened up the straps because I had them on comfy setting, you know, where they just sort of graze your belly. Oh, I love that. Thank God I've got a belly, otherwise I'd hit the deck. But she tightened up the straps to where they're supposed to be. And then she put one finger under the strap at the top. She put one finger underneath and she said, this is the rule. You're supposed to be able to only get one finger under the strap. And then she looked at me for a response. I don't know why I said the following. But when she said, one finger, that's the rule, one finger, I said, oh, that's interesting, because it's two for a dog's collar. Why the fuck did I say that? To make it worse, I then said, are you trying to stop me from losing my boobs in the park? Why am I still talking? Shut up! But there was one lady, and I asked her, why didn't you let your bra fit? And she was an older lady, and she said, when I took my bra off, my boobs went down like that, so they just measured me waist. Another lady said, I didn't like it because I didn't know the etiquette and I took my bra off too early. How is that? Was she still on the bloody bus?
Hello, it's Sarah Millican here. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. Don't forget to like, pop a comment below, and why not stick around to watch a few more? I'm sure those emails or those dishes can wait a bit longer.